Hello everybody, welcome back to Dominions 5. Let's continue our series as L.A. Tianqi. And here we go, this is going to be turn 8. Oh wow, I'm one of the last people. Alright, so we thought we might bump. And we didn't. Okay, interesting. Let's take a look at these battles. This is to the northwest. Oh, let me turn down my speaker sound here. Well, we just evaporate that first line. Good, routing everybody. This guy's on fire. Excellent. I saw we lost one there. So this can happen with the heavy cav is the archer heavy cav, is that after they've cleared like a group of units, sometimes they'll stick around and shoot an arrow. See, like right now, these guys are shooting arrows instead of charging in. So, but then they charge in. But see, now that guy's going to be alone, and these guys here are shooting arrows, right, instead of charging in. And so that leaves some of your more brave fellows out front a bit more exposed. So that's just something you have to deal with when you're dealing with heavy cav that also happen to be archers. Okay, here we had some heavy cav. Now my guys are on hold attack closest, so they should go and should be a charge versus a charge, and I think we pretty handled that pretty well. I don't think we lost. Oh, see? See? Good thing we brought two. Now, we happen to have a general in this fight, but even if we didn't, this shit happens all the time to these guys. So let's see, they probably got hit by an arrow. Yeah, see, I have them all the way in the back, and despite that, he just got wrecked by these light cavalry. That's why you bring two. Okay, Hoburgdorf. I wonder if this actually is going to give us Hoburgs. The PD type wasn't Hoburgs. So we have these guys on hold and attack closest. Oh, actually, that's really... Yeah, we're going to lose all the pikemen anyways. But that wasn't too bad. We got our big rout on the early squad. We do lose all the rest of our pikemen. That was a bit too bad. I can't remember in the last video why I decided that we wouldn't have these hold and attack. That certainly would have saved the life of the... of the pikemen. Okay, we lost a bunch of people. Because misfortune 3. Oh, excellent. Alright, I am happy we got this province. And, okay, we found Pangaea. Here's Lemuria. I'm assuming Pangaea is going to come up here. Let's go through this way here. I'd like to see... Oh, okay, well, actually, I could just look up here. Okay, interesting. So, what are we going to do here? Let's get some PD. We can get scouts here. Good to know. Crossbows and heavy cav. Interesting. So, first thing to check is... Suppose I had one of these guys. Where could he reinforce to? Not a lot of places. All right, let's get the easy turns out of the way. We're going to go here, obviously. This is just a little bit of deer tribes. This is going to be hold and attack. And they're going to be in front because it's Divine Blessing. And actually, the fact that this is a bunch of undead is great for our, this is a great thing for our, prophet to go and fight. Now, the question is, what do I do here? Because 20 crossbowmen and heavy cav... There's not going to be that much heavy cav, but we don't have a lot of units. So this is tricky. A little tricky. This can definitely take the woodsman and blowpipes. In fact, yeah, we kind of have to go here first because we need to claim it before Utgard does. I think we just do it. I think we just do this. Crossbow. So the issue is it depends how long it's going to take for the for my cavalry to kill the heavy cav. Because if it takes them a while, they're going to take a few crossbow hits, and we might lose one or two guys, and then we risk routing. And it's crossbows, so they might just kill my guys in the back. And also, Utgard might bump us, and we might die. So there's a lot of ways we die here. But we just kind of got to do it. Over here... Yeah, woodsmen, blowpipes, and vinemen. Sometimes you can have weird mages with these guys that cast like blood spells, but I think we'll be okay. And afterwards, maybe we reinforce, like maybe we do from here south and from here up here, and then we finish up here, something like that. Which means... I don't really need to do anything immediately with these guys. Let's get them in position here. All right, let's do a few things. I want to ping this throne. So we'll get a scout because that's just a good thing to have. We did ping that throne already. This throne we don't really need to ping. And let's get more scouts anyways. What I'm wondering is, does it pay to do this and go after this province here with the militia and the heavy infantry if Man still hasn't taken it? Has to take it, right? I think so. I'm trying to anticipate next turn where I might potentially want these guys. There's no way this kind of fails hard, unless we have an epic bump with Utgard, so that, I mean, that might happen. I think that's what we do. Let's get a scout here. There's potentially going to be a lot of Diplo next turn, so I'm certainly going to try to reach out to Erythea. And we're going to try to get a nap with Erythea. And assuming we get a nap with Erythea, we start construction of the fortress here right away. Now, in terms of recruitment, we actually got an Earth 2, Death 2. Next, we're going to get a Water 2, a Nature 2. And now what we need to do is get an Air 2 random. So we're going to keep recruiting from that. Now here, we could spam out a whole bunch of heavy cav. And we could recruit them elsewhere. But I want to get infrastructure going before I start spamming out units. So we're going to save that gold. And save up for our first fort that I do want to get started before too late. So that's the plan for that for now. This could be a fort province. I mean, we're going to try to get these stones and we'll try to fort them. I think that's the plan. This guy, we're just going to head out and start site searching. You know what's weird is that we didn't get a water 2 random. You almost always get at least one water 2 random. But we didn't, so that happens. Okay, so we're just going to start site searching. We're going to get Earth and Death going here. We'll get Nature 2 on the next guy. And then, honestly, we can just wait until we get an Air 2 random, because normally this guy's Death 2, but we already have Death 2 on this fellow. Okay, that's going to be it. A pretty short and simple turn. And there might be some Diplo between now and the next turn, now that I've met Utgard. We can see if they want to go after Lemuria or not, and we'll come up with a plan. So I'll see you guys then. Take care.